Okay, let's continue our journey on visual thinking. And last examples, we're working with Cartesian coordinates, and this time we'll take an example where we'll work with polar coordinates. So in this problem that has been adapted from a problem in Kleppner and Kollenkopf, the problem is a bead moves outwards with a constant speed u along the spoke of a wheel. It starts from the center at t equal to 0. The angular position of the spoke is given by theta equal to omega t, where omega is a constant. Find the trajectory of the particle and plot it. So let me explain you the problem in terms of a picture. We consider a wheel. It has got spokes. On these spokes, one of these spokes is a bead. And as this wheel rotates with the angular speed of omega, the angular position of this theta is given by theta equal to omega t, because it's traveling on the spoke, and on the spoke it's traveling with the constant speed u. We have to find out what is the trajectory of the bead. So let's go ahead and solve this problem. To solve this problem, we'll write down velocity and acceleration in the polar coordinates. Velocity in polar coordinates is given by r dot r hat plus r theta dot theta hat. And acceleration is given by r double dot minus r theta dot square r hat plus r theta double dot plus 2 r dot theta dot times theta hat. For this problem, we identify r dot is u, is always constant. Theta dot is omega, is also constant. Therefore, r is ut and theta is omega t. For the trajectory, the x coordinate is r cos theta, which is ut cos omega t, and y coordinate is r sin theta, which is ut sin omega t. So we started out with the polar coordinates, because in polar coordinates it was really straightforward to set up this problem. We have converted to Cartesian coordinates, which is what we are going to use to plot. For Cartesian coordinates, we have obtained the x and y coordinates, but now again, in order to plot, I need to get rid of these these equations of the physical dimensions. The physical dimensions, both x, y, r, all of these are dimensionable quantities. So we have to find out the natural scale for the quantities that are appearing in over here, and use those natural quantities in the problem to non-dimensionalize. In this particular problem, the natural length scale, we have two constants u and omega, and we have to find out the scale for time and scale for length. Using u and omega, these dimensions of length are given by u by omega, which has dimensions of length, and this provides a natural scale for length. For time, we have got 1 over omega. So we should go ahead and, in order to non-dimensionalize, we should replace all quantities of dimensions of length, such as x, y and r, by these dimensions. So we can simply go ahead and replace x by u by omega x, u by omega y and u by omega r. Similarly, for time, we can replace time by 1 over omega times t. And that replacement in the equations will simply give me x coordinate as omega by u times, this is the replacement I am doing, or I can also say big x coordinate is omega by u x, etc. And when I do that, for x and y coordinate, I simply get t cos t and t sin t. X and y are dimensionless coordinates and t is dimensionless time. We'll use parametric plot to make a plot for this thing. For parametric plot, we'll use a function called parametric plot. This is a new function, you're seeing it for the first time. So parametric plot works in the following way. Inside curly brackets, you give the x coordinate and the y coordinate. The x coordinate in this case are t cosine t, and y coordinates are t sin t. And I'm going to make a plot for t from 0 to 20, and I'll label the axis as the x and y. So when I execute that, I got the out spiral, and this is exactly what we expect the trajectory of the bead to be on the wheel as the bead moves outwards and the wheel rotates with an angular velocity of omega. So the bead is going to have a trajectory that is spiraling out like this, and that's what this plot shows. In order to make this plot, we have used the parametric plot function. Alternatively, we could have also used a polar plot function by using the r and theta coordinates. So for polar plot function, we need to know the equation of this in terms of polar coordinates, and in terms of polar coordinates, we simply get r is equal to ut, and substituting time in terms of theta, that is eliminating time out of this equation, we get r by theta equal to u by omega, or in other words, r equal to ut, theta equal to omega t, eliminating time, we get r equal to u by omega theta. So that becomes my equation in polar coordinates. For this equation in polar coordinates, I can make a plot directly in terms of polar coordinates. I can go ahead and do a non-dimensionalization by making this translation, r goes to u by omega, and let me call it big R. So for that particular purpose, this equation becomes u by omega capital R equals u by omega theta, which gives me R equal to theta, and that is nothing but an equation of a out spiral. I can also make this by a parametric by a polar plot. For polar plot, I give equation of R in terms of theta, in which case this is just theta, and I say theta goes from 0 to 2 pi. This should be theta. I got a out spiral just like over there, but since I want to cover a few circles, I should make this maybe 10 pi, and there we go. We get the same plot as over there. In this particular case, we use the parametric plot by converting the coordinates to x and y coordinates and making a parametric plot with respect to dimensionless time for x and y coordinates. Over here, we use directly the polar plot function to make a plot using polar coordinates, where you have to specify the first argument as r as a function of theta and provide a range for theta. So again, there are multiple ways of making the plots, and you have to find the most reasonable way of making a plot given the problem, given the coordinate system, and whichever is most suitable and easier to use. So finally, let's interpret from this solution. So the question that I have for you is, what is the effect of changing omega and u on this trajectory? If I change omega and u, how is this trajectory going to change? And as you already know, that changing omega and u is not going to change this trajectory. That is, this one solution in the plot contains all the solutions corresponding to varied values in u and omega. Can you explain how that is possible, that a single solution covers all the values of u omega, or what is the effect of u and omega on this plot? Give it a moment of thought, and I'll explain it to you in a moment. The equations that we have obtained over here don't contain any u and omega. They're independent of u and omega. That is why our solution or this plot is independent of u and omega. So what does u and omega actually change? U and omega in this case change the length scale, the units in which we measure x, y, and t. As we change u and omega, we change the scale with which measure u, y, and t. On this particular plot, the meaning of one unit of x or one unit of y will change if I change u and omega. Similarly, if I change omega, the unit, the time is moving along this trajectory. Whether this is a fast out spiral or a slow out spiral, that will depend on what is the frequency omega. If the omega frequency is very high, then the time scales are small, and the consequence is that wheel spinning faster than and it's moving slowly outwards, and the consequence of that will be this will be a slow out spiral. If omega is small, then this is going to be a fast out spiral. That means the bead will move very fast on this out spiral. If the omega is small, the bead will be moving very slowly on this out spiral. So by changing u and omega, we change the length and the time scale. In this particular problem, our solution remains, the non-dimensionalized version of the solution remains independent of the parameters of the problem, that is u and omega.